Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning Channel. In Flame 2017 Extension 1, the batch node compositing environment has undergone significant usability improvements. This video will cover some of the smaller but significant enhancements to batch. Bigger features such as the compass, elbow node, start frame and more will be covered in other batch-specific videos. The updated functionalities are not footage-specific, so you can use any media to follow along. Just use any batch flow graph that consists of a few nodes connected together. Please note that what you're about to cover is available in Batch, Batch Effects, and the Modular Keyer. Let's start off with some simple functionality like copy and paste. When it comes to copying and pasting nodes, the pasted selection will always appear under cursor, regardless whether you use the contextual menu or keyboard shortcuts. For example, select this node and copy it. You could use the contextual menu or press Ctrl+C. When it came to pasting nodes in prior versions of Flame using the keyboard shortcuts, the nodes would normally be pasted next to the copied node. So if you wanted to paste the node at the end of your flow graph, and the copied node was at the beginning, there would be a lot of manual node moving. In Flame 2017 Extension 1, when you paste the nodes with the contextual menus or Ctrl+V, the nodes will appear under cursor using any technique. This is much more intuitive and faster to use. This under cursor functionality has also been extended to the new batch import node. So whether you drag out the import node to a location or use the Meta I keyboard shortcut, the media import window appears and you can locate the media you wish to import and load it into batch. As before, note that the media has been placed in the correct position according to the last cursor position. It's just worth mentioning that the media will always be imported into batch schematic reel 1, and you can move it to the other reels. This won't affect the positioning of the clip in the batch schematic. Finally, the same under cursor behavior has been applied to exploding BFX clips. So take a BFX clip, call up the contextual menu, and choose explode effects. The flow graph will appear around the cursor location. And as an added bonus, the original structure of the flow graph is restored as well. Now let's move on to changes in selection functionality. In previous versions, users reported difficulty in adding and removing nodes in a selection. In the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products, all the node selection behavior has been standardized. You can click on individual nodes one at a time as before. If you wanted to add other nodes to the selection, hold Ctrl and click on the nodes. At this point, you can click down to hold the selection and move the nodes around. Just be aware that you can deselect the selection by tapping anywhere else in the batch schematic. And you can also deselect the selection by quick clicking on any node. If you want to add the nodes back into the selection, just hold Ctrl and click the nodes again. Now to remove one node from an existing selection, hold Ctrl and click on the node. Please excuse the pun, but it's all about control in this case. So that's adding and removing one node at a time. In order to make multi-node selections in one go, you use the rectangular selection box. Hold Ctrl and drag a box selection around a group of nodes. Now every time you control drag a box selection around a set of nodes, it deselects the original selection and creates a new one. If you wanted to add or remove nodes using a box selection, you hold Ctrl Shift and drag over the specific nodes. This is now the same selection behavior that you will find in other design applications. This selection functionality has also been extended into the action schematic. The penultimate topic covered in this video is the batch notes. Go to the batch node bin and scroll over to the far right. When you drag a note, it is now fully expanded by default. So you can place it, click on its text box, and start writing your note straight away. So this can be used extensively for collaborative workflows. What's really great is that the physicality and location remains the same, even if you save this as a setup. So if you reload this on this machine or elsewhere, the note will remember if it was expanded or collapsed, and it will remember its position in the batch flow graph. This can also work with the new compass node, which you can see in detail in another video. Finally, for those of you using the OpenClip publish workflow, there has been an adjustment to the right node. When you double-click on the right node for its menus, you now have some additional choices when it comes to versioning. Switching from no version to custom version allows you to define the render version number as before. And if you switch to the render list, you will see a new version number column. This shows you the current version number set for the render. When using custom version, you can also click and drag this value to increase or decrease the version number when needed. However, if you have been using the iteration functionality in batch, you can get the versioning to follow the iteration numbering instead. So switch back to the right node menu. Change the pull-down menu from custom version to follow iteration. You will note that the version number is locked to the iteration number. So if you click iterate and increment the batch setup, the version number will update based on the current iteration number. This will help you identify the renders and their associated iterated batch setups. And finally, since this number is locked to the iteration, when you go to the render list menu, the version number cannot be edited like the custom version number. These may be small improvements, but you have a total visual feedback in either the right node menu or the render list. So we've covered loads of small but useful batch improvements. Don't forget, there are quite a few other improvements in batch that are covered in other videos. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.